Okay, so you are about to watch Mrs. Shields and I play the global warming game. And before we get into that game, you're actually going to be completing a couple backgrounds and seeing a puppet show so you have a better understanding of the game. This is what the game board is actually going to look like. And so to start, I wanted you to tackle these couple background questions. So what's in blue is what's going to be added to your work. So here's the background for the global warming game. In real life, there's no solid barrier like plastic wrap to trap heat. Instead, heat is trapped on Earth by gases in the atmosphere that are called greenhouse gases. So the scientific term for heat trapping gases are greenhouse gases. Now you might be like, why is she mentioning plastic wrap? So remember the experiment that I conducted with Mrs. Shields's help, where we had the 2 2-liter bottles, one without plastic wrap on top and one with plastic wrap. And we saw that plastic wrap allow that bottle to reach a higher temperature. So that was modeling the greenhouse effect, but now we're learning, okay, it's not really a solid barrier, it's greenhouse gases. Now, obviously, when we think about the greenhouse effect and global warming, climate change, it has to do with the sun. So we have to understand a little bit about energy from the sun. So we know that energy from the sun travels in waves, but it also carries energy. And scientists call these tiny energy packets photons, not protons, photons. And so the ones that they come in different wavelengths. And so based on those wavelengths of light, you probably remember that from sixth grade, some of these photons we see, and they're called visible light photons, they come directly from the sun. But we also have photons that instead of seeing, we feel as heat, and those are called infrared. Sometimes students have heard of infrared if you have been to the works, and they have that camera you can stand in front of, and you can see the hot and cold parts of your body. That's using infrared energy. So again, visible light photons we see, photons that we feel as heat are called infrared. Those are going to be important in the puppet show that you're about to see.